Okay, O to B. Okay, it's level. Right, so it's embankments are slope of 1 is to 1.5. Okay, O to rough, here is going to be an embankment because all the numbers are below 75. And from here to here is going to be a cut. Okay, because the numbers are above 75. Now, I'm going to do that now. Alright. Okay. 15. Excuse me. Okay, now, the spaces between them are 7.5 because the contours are rising in 5 meter vertical intervals and the ratio is 1 is to 1.5. So you multiply 5 by 1.5. Now, what I'm doing at the moment is bisecting a 15 millimeter, okay, for accuracy. That's what I'm doing. And I'm going to mark up 15s here as well. Yes. So many problems with this question. Things moving on me, projectors are okay, visualizer not working. Right, this is like I'd say the fifth or sixth attempt of having it. So hopefully second, sixth time lucky. So we're going into a half day. Okay, now here we go up here as well. Right, 75, okay, 60, 70, 65, 60, 65, okay, and then, another 7.5, okay, here leaves 50 in there. Right, put your compass here on O. Okay, bring it out to the contour 50. Okay, so there's the 50 contour. 55. Okay, 60. Okay, 65. There you go. Now, here are the marks for them. Now, there'll be a little intersection here. So this is at 70, this one. Okay, so that's at 70, 65, 60, 55. So there's 55. Okay, 60, 65. Here, so we'll freehand sketch them together, and there'll be an intersection here, and that's where we'll heavy in here. Make sure to leave in your light lines there to get the marks for the construction. Now, from there to there is a cut because the numbers are above 75 and the ratio for the cut is 1 to 1, so the contour lines are 5 meters apart. Okay, so this is at 75. The next one is going to be at 80. So there's 80, right, and then after then 85, 90, 95, don't think we need to go for 95, right, okay, so that was at 80, alright, this is at 85, there's 90, okay, back down to 85, back down to 80, and there's the 75, so we can freehand sketch them in. posters or artworks. Now, B to C is a court, or sorry, B to C is an embankment and it's on a rising road. The road raises 1:20. So if I travel 200 metres, I'd have risen vertically by 10 metres. If I travel 100 metres, I've risen vertically by 5 metres. So that's at 80 metres, because B is at 75. To figure out the cone, vertical distance between X and B is 5 metres. So 5 multiplied by 1.5 would get me 7.5. So the radius of the cone is 7.5. So I'm going to set, what you call it, my cone to 7.5. I'm going to draw a tangent line to the base of the cone. I'm going to mark up in 15s and then the 7.5s. And then go parallel to the, what you call it, start line. So that's at the lower, okay, the basal cone is at the lower point, so 75. So this is at, okay, 70, because it's an embankment. So there's the 71, and the 70 again. Okay, so then 65 there. Okay, next one at 60. Okay, next one at 55, and that'll be that done then. So that was at 70. Okay, 65, 60, okay, 55. And we can freehand sketch them in then. This one loops a bit more. Okay, that's too messy there at the top. So there's an embankment there. Now we have to do part B, is to do a vertical section through line DE after the earthworks have been done. So a vertical section, okay, and point E is at 65. Okay, point D, right, is at 55. So I'm going to have to mark lines down 5 millimeters. Okay, because the ground contours are 5 millimeters. Okay, I'll mark a few lines up as well. So I'm marking up in fives. I'm going to draw horizontal lines through them. So that's at 60, that's at 55, point D, okay, D is at an altitude of 55, so that's point D, now 65, okay, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90. Right, so these we set is at 65, or sorry, not 60, 65, I was on about 55 rather. So 50, okay. But the thing is, right, even though D is at 55, okay, on contour line, the whole surface, okay, the putting green is at 75. So realistically, right, okay, after the earthworks has been done, that's where the start point starts, right, okay. And then you go here, right, okay, now, that's at 75 as well, because it's the putting green, it's absolutely flat. Now, this point here, right, okay, so we the slope of 1 is to 1, or sorry, no, what am I about, not that point, okay, or sorry, this one rather, so this is our point there. Now, that's at point 60, that contour, that point in the contour, so we're going up to 60. So it's going to be a heavy line here, okay, because DE runs through the earthworks, okay, and then it's going to be a sloped line here, okay, oh, yeah, that's right, okay, and then the rest of it then, okay, is going to be, what you call it, the rest of it then is going to be all the squealy stuff, the curved profile, right, so this is that. 65, okay, at this one is at 70, okay, now this is at sorry, did I say that was at 70, okay, which is correct, that's at 70, right, the next one then is at 75. One is at 80, these, okay, 85 then, okay, these two guys are at 90, okay, back down to, oh sorry, I marked the wrong ones there, so I'll have to do that, mark them again, so sorry, these are the actual ones. It's easy to make a mistake to actually start following your part of your earthworks. Okay, it's very easy to make that mistake. So there we go. Those two are at 90. Now this is at 85. So 85, then 80, and 70, and we can freehand sketch them in. Okay, now, part B of the question, or part C rather, so we have a golf ball hit from point E, which is struck in a westerly direction, maximum altitude of 15 metres, okay, after travelling a horizontal distance of 100 metres in plan. In the profile, determine the position of the ball on the green when the ball initially lands. Alright, so initially lands, so it says at point E, on so point E in the fairway, okay, it travels, okay, a maximum of, or after traveling 100 meters, it reaches its maximum height. So its maximum height. So here's point E. Okay, now, it said the maximum altitude was 115. Okay. So 90, 95, 100, 105, 110. Let me do this one more. There's 115. Now, okay, here's where it starts, right? Okay, so 100 meters, so I'm going to divide the bottom into 65, 115 is, that's 50, so I'll divide it into 5 segments, 20, 40, 60, 80, so vertical lines, now E up to 115. Okay, I'll divide, mark this in tens, which should be already done, so it's the rectangle method. There's a point in the parabola. Okay, the next one, fourth one. There's the start point. We can get our, we can mirror them across with our compass. Okay, probably be easier just for. No, never mind. I'll just mirror them across. Okay, watch you don't mix them up. So what I mean by mix them up is mark them on the wrong altitude line. Okay, that'd be the easy thing to mix up, is marking them, you'd mark it on a contour altitude. Okay, rather than the mirror line for the parabola. Okay. Then you want to swing the bottom over. So you can freehand sketch it in. There's the point. And then one last thing to do, join those together. Here's what it looks like when it's done. Here's our solution from SEC. There we go. Thank you.